is constantly changing. How can I be sure where I stand with you?
Thank goodness. I have a flat tire. I don't seem to have a jack.
Oh, dear, I don't know if I can help. My husband usually... Let me have a look. I think it's somewhere out in here. Let me have a look. Oh, yeah, here it is.
Oh. Shut up! Oh. Won't get hurt. Stop!
No, Blaine. Please don't take me. I don't want to go. I don't want to go. No.
She's been given tranquilizers.
Then why is she still so distressed?
Side effect of the drugs, I'm afraid.
Must be something you can give her to calm her down properly.
Long term, yes. If she is suffering from some form of mania, lithium will eventually help control her mood swings.
Then why not give her that?
Mental conditions like this are very hard to identify precisely. Like I said, now we've stabilized her, we need to think about getting her some form of specialist treatment. It'll take time. The hospital's 60 miles away. You know she doesn't want to go.
I know.
Perhaps if you'd come back in the morning, try to talk around.
Things just got on top of her, Oscar. Could happen to any of us.
I think there's a bit more to it than that, Gina.
Oh, so you're with Dr. Trent, are you? You'd like to see her put away somewhere?
Of course not. Don't be silly. Now, come on, we've got a wedding to think about as well, you know.
Oh, yeah. Chin up. Teeth and smiles. Teeth and smiles.
Thanks.
Sorry, I'm late. Stopped to check a car on the moor. Left with his boot wide open. Nobody seemed to be around.
Well, he's probably a courting couple with other things on their mind.
Well, I suppose so. After all, love is in the air.
For some, maybe. Cheers.
A properly organised wedding needs a checklist, Rosie. Here, have a look. Can I have a scotch and three halves, please, Gina?
Flippin' heck. You've more boxes to tick there than an MOT.
All going smoothly then, Vernon?
The secret, of course, is to leave nothing to chance. I've just been round to the printers to pick up the church service programmes.
And?
No emissions, no names misspelt, and the hymn numbers in the right order. They followed my instructions to the letter.
My dad's offer to pay for everything was very generous, Ben.
I know. It's very good of him. I just wish you'd warned him against trusting Vernon's scripts.
He only had 2 days before he had to go back to Ireland. He had to give the responsibility of the organisation to someone.
Vernon Scripps, responsibility and organisation do not belong in the same sentence.
He's offered his services for nothing. I can't interfere now.
The biggest day of our lives is in the hands of the most incompetent man north of Watford.
Vernon's heart is in the right place.
Will the wedding cars be?
I'm keeping a very tight eye, don't worry. Come here.
Hello. Is that you again? Oh, say something, for goodness sake.
I'm now going to tell you where to pick up your instructions.
What have you done with her? Please, don't harm my wife.
Follow instructions. Leave the police right out of this. You'll see your wee wifey again.
Promise me you won't harm her.
Thank you.
P's in the whole region. Avoid the ones with an asterisk. One tends to hear a lot of delighted to help out, my dear, or was pleased to be of service to the fairer sex.
I recognize the syndrome.
So, that's pretty much everything. How was Jenny yesterday?
Still refusing treatment.
Can I help?
Possibly. Dennis may need some support this morning.
I think marriage is a great institution. Then again, who wants to live in an institution? Well, it's a funny line, yeah?
Well, it was funny when Groucho Marx said it.
I thought the best man was supposed to say something amusing about the groom, not just crack old jokes.
Well, hardly know, Ben. She'd never have agreed to doing this in the first place.
Folks expect a proper witty speech from the best man. It's a highlight of the reception.
And thank you for your huge encouragement.
Walker. You reported a vehicle abandoned in suspicious circumstances, yes?
Yeah, on the moors last night, Sarge. We're still there this morning.
Anything come up?
No report of it being stolen. I'm still waiting for details of the current owner.
Well. Meanwhile, we have orders from HQ. Another crackdown on unpaid road tax. So I'd like you two out there checking those discs. On you go.
How are things at the hospital, Sarge?
Not good, I'm afraid, Alf. Would you mind taking calls for me? I won't be available for an hour or so. Thank you.
This is supposed to be a free country. I can discharge myself whenever I want.
That's not quite the position, Jenny.
Mrs. Jennifer Merton to you. I'm not your patient. I don't see what this has to do with you.
What Dr. Trent means is it's our duty as doctors to decide on your future treatment together.
You can't make me go to this mental asylum.
It's not an asylum, Jenny. Dr. Lawson wants you to go into the psychiatric hospital for a short stay.
Don't try and butter me up. You betrayed me, and I will never trust you again.
Jenny, you're suffering from a form of manic psychosis. You need treatment from specialists.
Suddenly, I'm a mad woman. If you know so much about it, why are you sending me away to other doctors then?
Jenny, no one's saying you're a mad woman.
Before I was forcibly brought in here, I was doing a responsible job. Looking after our house, feeding you, ironing your precious police shirt, your precious uniform. Now, how can I manage all that if I am so mad?
Jenny, love, please.
You want to send me away to a madhouse because you want to be rid of me? Well, I'm not going. I'm leaving whether you like it or not.
Jenny, listen to the doctors. You can't just leave.
Jenny, please.
Leave this to us.
This must be very distressing for you.
It's more distressing for Jenny. And she seems to be getting worse in here. Maybe you should just let her come home with me.
Dr. Lawson can't allow that. When Jenny's manic, she's at real risk of harming herself.
What are we going to do then?
If she won't go voluntarily, she'll have to be sectioned.
And what if I don't agree to that?
We'd prefer it if you did, but in the end, we can insist.
Surely her family must have some say.
The decision can be made by two doctors, without reference to relatives.
I think you should listen to professional advice, Dennis.
Speaking as a doctor or a friend?
Both. The sooner she gets proper treatment, the better.
Anthony!
Don't you dare come near me! Get off me! Get off me! Leave me alone! Leave me be!
All right.
Get off me!
All right. We're just going to take you back to your room for now.
No!
All right. If there's no other way.
Sorry to be leaving Aidensfield at a time like this.
Don't be. You and Ben must live your lives to the full. I wish you well.
Thanks, Dennis.
And from what Dr. Lawson says, this psychiatric hospital has an excellent reputation.
I know it must seem bleak at the minute, but I am certain you are doing the best any husband could do for his wife.
We'll be all right.
Thanks, Liz.
I bet with a good scrub down, wash away the grease and the grime, it'd be real special.
I don't know about that.
Hi, Rosie.
Oh. Thanks, Oscar.
I'd like a quiet table for two, if possible.
All our tables are quiet. We don't encourage noisy customers.
No, sorry, I don't.
You can have a table in the snug, Mr. Trent.
Thank you, Gina, and it's Matthew, please.
Let's wait till I know you a bit better, eh?
Ah! Good timing, darling. Lovely. Gina's just organised us a table.
I'm afraid I haven't time for more than a sandwich. I'm running late.
Right. The house that Vernon Scripps suggested is off the market. One or two worth looking at, though.
Oh, this one's lovely.
I started first time. There's petrol in the tank. There's nothing to indicate that it's broken down, over.
Actually, Rob, I've just heard back from records.
The car's registered owner is a Mrs. Angela Price, 2 Beechwood Drive, Ashfordley. Over.
Not known to us, is she? Over.
No. Beechwood Drive's very smart. No ne'er-do-wells live round there.
I'm looking for a girl who has no face. She has no name or number. And so I search within this lonely place, knowing that but I can't stop this feeling deep inside of me. Ruling my mind, I feel no sound. Don't know where.
Understand they're sending her to a psychiatric hospital.
Where have you been?
A mental hospital, Phil.
Poor old Merton. Oh, hi, Sarge. We were just taking a break. I've checked the town centre. Car, exercise, discs.
Walker's covering the villages.
Actually, there's something I want to tell you. I've requested leave for domestic reasons, starting tomorrow. And Division have agreed that as longest-serving officer at Bellamy, you will be acting sergeant.
Oh, really? Oh, right.
Don't know when I'll be back. Have to consider what's best for Jenny.
Yeah, it looks great, this. Just the job. Yes, well, it wasn't the cheapest quote, but you get what you pay for in life, David.
You didn't pay for it. Dr. Merrick's dad did.
I am responsible for the budget, David.
Morning, Vernon. David. Marquee looks good. Lands if it rains, though.
Fully waterproof, and the side flaps go up in knots under 2 minutes.
Oh, you thought of that, then?
When I undertake a task, Ben, I think of everything. Now, just stop fretting.
That's not me. I trust you implicitly. No, it's Liz. She's a bit concerned. You know what brides are like about their special day.
Yes, well, tell her not to worry her pretty little head. A caterer's meeting next, David.
Looking good here, Ben.
Yeah, so far.
Listen, I know you've got a lot on your plate, what with the wedding and everything, but could you take a drive up to the top farm for me?
It's vacant. Jake Armitage gave up the tenancy about a week ago.
No, I'm just on a short sublet for some tourists.
Ah, I didn't realise.
Yeah, I'm sorry, it must have slipped my mind. If you just make sure everything's in order up there.
Right.
Morning, Gordon.
I understood this was a personal visit.
I don't mind the uniform, it is.
Ah, right. Good.
It's very personal, in fact. I'm afraid my wife has what seems to be a long-term illness.
Very sorry to hear that.
Naturally, there are certain financial matters arising from this that I need to discuss with you.
Good to see you both. How's everything going for the wedding?
Absolutely fine, Jerry. David's suitcase.
Yeah, the tent's up, and it's got those side flap things that you can close up in case it rains.
Lord be to God, what will they think of next?
Yeah, well, Mr. Burley always says you should be prepared for every adventure.
Eventuality?
Indeed you do, that's a fact.
So sorry I'm late, Dad.
Not at all. Vernon's arranged a taxi for me and everything.
Thank you, Vernon.
He's doing a first-rate job all round, by the sound of it.
Ben had a word with me earlier.
Did he? Oh, don't mind him, Vernon. He's just anxious that everything runs smoothly on the big day. I know you'll do a grand job myself. I have no worries on that score.
Nor should you have.
I'll grant an increased overdraft facility. I'll organise an arrangement with the branch near where your wife will be treated.
Thank you, Gordon. I appreciate it.
So our wives are very important to us, aren't they?
How's Angela?
Oh, fine, fine. Up to her eyes with this weekend's WI fate.
Well, thanks again, Gordon.
Find out what he wants.
Hello, can I help you?
Oh, hi, I'm from the estate. Just a quick call, check everything's okay.
Oh, it's fine. Lovely spot up here.
My boss asked me to look in on you.
Oh, well, I can assure you were treating the place well. No breakages, anything like that.
No, I'm sure.
My husband's out walking, but you're welcome to come in and inspect the place.
No, that won't be necessary.
Perhaps you'd care for a cup of tea?
Well, actually, I'd better get on. I'm getting married tomorrow.
Really? Then she's a lucky wee girl, whoever she is.
I'd better get back. Enjoy your stay.
Don't think he knew anything.
You better pray he doesn't.
Then I ask you to take your vows as man and wife, do blah blah, etc. And then the best man passes the ring. Do you have a ring?
Oh, I'm not the actual best man, or that's Constable Walker. And he can't be here because he's a
constable. So I'm sort of like the second best man.
David, the vicar knows all that. I gave you a stand-in ring.
Oh, right, so you want the thingy?
It's all right, we can pretend.
No, we can't pretend. Let's rehearse this properly.
Yeah, there we go. It's not our ring as such. It's more a washer from the garage.
David, it's a ring. For these purposes, it's a ring. Now, can we please get on?
It is a bit greasy. Maybe we'll just pretend as Liz says.
Then I pronounce you man and wife, blah-de-blah, the organ plays, da-de-da, and you walk back down the aisle together.
Blah-de-blah, da-de-da, how am I supposed to take timings from that?
Yes? What is it? Can I help you?
I'm PC Walker. I'm looking for Mrs. Price, your wife, presumably. Is she in?
No, not at the moment. What's this all about?
Could we discuss this inside?
Yes, that's her key.
Have you any idea why she would leave the car like that?
Angela's a bit scatty, sometimes forgets where she's parked, leaves it for days.
Yeah, but why park there in the first place? It's miles from anywhere.
Well, she likes going for walks. Probably met a friend on the moors, came back in her car, forgot her own. She's like that.
Still, I'd like to talk to her myself.
Well, she's not breaking any law leaving it on the moors, is she?
Where is she, sir?
Visiting a friend in York. I don't know the number. She's away for the weekend.
Well, I'll keep hold of the keys for now. If she contacts you, ask her to phone me at Aidensfield Police Station. She can come and collect them.
Now listen, Vicky, you're going to have a full house for once. So don't go milking it and letting the service overrun.
The real difficulty is the distance. The specialist hospital is 60 miles away.
Have you thought about transferring?
No sergeant posts are currently available. If I do transfer, I'd have to accept a demotion.
Yeah, it's a tough prospect. Once you've had stripes,
I know. If Jenny were put under section, she'd need my support.
Yeah. Dr. Trent, just coming to see you.
Liz phoned from the hospital. We need to get over there now.
Liz asked me to delay the sectioning until she talked to your wife once more.
We all felt that sectioning should be a last resort. I thought it was worth one more try to persuade her to go voluntarily.
And?
She wants to talk to you.
We're close by if you need us.
How are you feeling? Sorry about the row earlier. Liz said you wanted to talk to me. And I so want to talk to you. Jenny, my love. You know I love you, don't you? I so love you.
Frightened, Dennis. Really scared about what's happening. If I do as they say, will this treatment make me better?
They say it will. But it would be so much better if you agree to go yourself.
I'm terrified about what's happening inside me. It's like all the wires are crossed. All right.
Thank you.
It's the pits, darling. Back and beyond. Absolute pits. And tonight, I've got some dreadful blokey stag do at the local boozer. Anyway, how about that nice little bar? King's Road, Tuesday night? That's the one. Oh, sorry, old girl, I've got to go.
Hello, darling. Just a quick call to the estate agents.
One whiskey.
Thank you, Oscar. Right, this should steady the nerves.
No need to be nervous. Marriage makes a man.
Well, how would you know? You've never been married.
It's a saying, David.
One that explains quite a lot in your case.
What I meant was, marriage can teach a man many things.
Yes. You learn how to be the man of the house, wear the trousers, and tell the wife what's what. You also learn to duck when she tells you back.
My idea of heaven, a room full of ladies, and vintage champagne.
This is wonderfully generous of you, Matthew.
Not at all. Rosie?
I've never had proper champagne before.
Let me introduce you to its pleasures. You look wonderful. You still in those nasty overalls.
Give over.
I'm not being funny, but isn't a hen party meant to be just for hens?
That's right, you better be getting along, darling. The chaps will be wondering where you've got to.
Hint taken. Sadly, ladies, I must leave you. Enjoy the champers. Bye, darling. Bye.
Thank you. Ta-ra.
I know Jenny means a lot to you. We're just trying to do our best for her. Well, let's hope so, eh?
Cheers, girls!
Cheers!
Well, we'll see how she settles in, but I'm a bit more optimistic now.
Oh, that's good news.
Will this affect your decision to transfer? Haven't had time to take it in yet. You'd like to stay.
Ah, here he comes! Last night of freedom, Ben.
If I know my own daughter, even out in exotic Africa, you won't be able to stray far.
It wouldn't even cross my mind. Had a tempting offer this afternoon, as a matter of fact. Just walked away.
Oh, did you indeed? Who's been giving you the eye then?
That holiday tenant out on Top Farm. Country woman of yours, Dennis, by the sounds of her voice.
From Glasgow, was she?
Oh, my husband's away. Will you know, step in for a wee cup of tea?
Must be Edinburgh. Glasgow, we drink our tea out of the saucer.
We've been watching you, Gordon. We saw the police come round.
They found Angela's car. I didn't tell them anything, I swear I didn't.
I do hope not, Gordon.
I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Call out the swapper, let's have a whopper. But get me to the church on time.
Drink, Sarge. I'd like to, but it's been a long day. Oh, well.
Ben will understand. Oh, there was one more thing, Sarge. You know Gordon Price, the bank manager, don't you?
I saw him today, actually. Why?
Well, that abandoned car's his wife's. He made light of it, says she's scatty and does it all the time.
Did you speak to her?
No. She's gone away, he said. To York.
Oscar!
They're her friends. I don't know the number, I'm afraid.
Gordon, you told me that Angela was busy with WI Fate this weekend.
I didn't want this getting around.
What?
She's been having an affair. She's left me.
So she just walked off across the moors, leaving her car with a key in the ignition?
Well, she must have met her lover there, went off in his car. I know I should have said all this to your constable, but it's honestly not a police matter.
He's no ruddy use at all.
You're confident all will go smoothly tomorrow, then?
Yes. Because of meticulous planning, Jerry. Everything's organised to the last detail.
Like the main voyage of the Titanic.
You know, Bernard, it's no wonder you became a funeral director.
Who is this lover?
I don't know.
You and Angela always seemed a very happy couple.
Well, appearances can be deceptive.
I find it hard to believe that Angela's just run off with another man. You've no idea who it is. Why are you lying to me, Gordon? Where's Angela? If you don't tell me where she is, I'm going to have to get CID in here and turn this place over.
She's been kidnapped. They said they'd kill her if I tell the police. They mean it.
Managed to get any sleep?
None at all.
I'm pretty certain no one's watching the house. The division will have men on hand at the bank.
I don't care about the bank. I just want my Angela back.
Have you thought any more about those calls?
I told you, female voice, quite posh, but muffled, that's all.
Local accent?
She was never on that long.
Anything at all, any wee detail that might give us a clue.
Hang on. She once said, "Wee wifey." I suppose she could be Scottish.
Sorry, Ben. Is Walker with you? I need to speak to him. And you. They're expecting Gordon Price to let them into the bank in about an hour. And he's convinced they'll kill his wife if he doesn't.
And we've no idea where they're holding her.
We have one shot in the dark. The woman who called Price had a posh Scottish accent. Now, the woman you mentioned up at Top Farm?
She was Scottish, yeah. Sounded like Miss Jean Brodie.
But you know the layout inside. Look, I know it's your wedding day, but you have time to come up to the farm with me now.
Mind of its own, my hair. You have done an amazing job given the challenge.
Give over. You look absolutely beautiful. Ben's a lucky man.
What a vision. If you weren't my own daughter and I wasn't old enough to be your father, I'd marry you myself. Relax, fellas. They'll have gone to the pub for a bit of Dutch courage.
I've searched there. I've searched everywhere.
Nobody's seen either of them. Lord Ashley said that Mr. Norton's Land Rover's disappeared as well.
What's happened?
How many doors into the house?
Just front and side. There's a living room on the right between them. I don't know where she came from there when she opened the door.
All right, I'll take the front, Walker. You go into the side when I say yes.
What do you want me to do?
You stay here. You're a civilian. And besides, you get married today, aren't you?
Phil, is that you? Look, I'm sorry to bother you, but we can't find Ben or Rob anywhere.
Gina, we've got something big on. I can't talk at the moment.
Something's up. He hung up on me. Oh, Liz, you look gorgeous.
Indeed, indeed you do.
You all look a bit... There's nothing wrong, is there?
No. Everything's tickety-boo, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes?
Morning. I'm a police officer. There have been a few burglaries recently at isolated properties in the area. Do you mind if I pop in and look at your security arrangements?
We're only on holiday here. You need to contact the owner.
Excuse me. Don't mind. Sorry, Mrs. Price.
Was he alone?
I didn't see anyone else.
Well, we're there all right. Two squad cars, some officers armed.
He's bluffing.
We're at the bank as well. You men won't get away. The position's hopeless.
Even if they are out there, I'm holding a gun. Got hostages to bargain with. If you're stupid enough to come here unarmed and alone, it's your position that's hopeless, pal.
Someone's out there.
Tell them to show themselves.
Walker, stay down. You all in position?
Yes, sir. We're all here. Got the front covered as well, Sergeant.
Oh, they're on this side as well.
Walker, grab her.
Everyone okay?
What do you think you're doing here? I told you to stay away.
Just a couple of jokers in wedding gear, you stupid Scotch cow.
Help, police, don't move.
Is Angela all right?
We just had the call, she's fine. The constable will take you home.
Thank you. Thank you, officer.
Well done, Sarge. You were brilliant.
Yeah, certainly takes a brave man to do it.
You're supposed to be in church or something?
They caused you in precisely 35 seconds. I mean, I thought of everything that could go wrong. How can you plan for the groom and best man vanishing into thin air? Oh, of course, they blame me, won't they? Oh, yes, Vernon's blown it again. It's so unfair, David.
No, wait, Mr. Vernon! They're here!
Sorry, it's lit here yet.
Due any second now, get in! Never again, David. Never again.
Who giveth this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
I, Ben Arthur Norton, take thee, Elizabeth Nuala Merrick, to my wedded wife.
I, Ben Arthur Norton, take thee, Elizabeth Nuala Merrick, to my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health.
Marriage often works best when husband and wife are different, when opposites attract. That's certainly true of Liz and Ben. Liz is witty, sensitive, intelligent, and beautiful. And Ben is... well, Ben. Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to Liz and Ben Norton and a long and happy marriage.
There's a man. Come on, you two. Ready?
Nice speech.
Okay.
Very funny.
Ready to cut the cake?
Thanks.
Ready?
All my own work.
Put it on the cake. Ready? Big smiles. Bigger. That's it. And cut. Lovely.
Yay! Yes. Well done, Matthew. If you give me the film, I'll get the prints.
Oh, right, eh? Yeah.
You're a powerful man, Vernon. I have to give you that.
It was nothing, really.
No, no, all thanks to you. A special day passed off flawlessly.
Gosh, I envy you two going off to Kenya. It's a wonderful country. I wish you all the best.
We're just popping off to change.
God bless you, my girl.
I propose a drink whilst we wait.
Come on, Vernon, drink up.
Comes, the hero of the hour.
They say you'll definitely get a commendation, sir.
He was great. Cool as you like.
I just dropped in to see. Oh, Bellamy's still in temporary charge till you hear from division.
Oh, well, I'll do the best that I can till you get back, Sarge.
I'm sorry to say I won't be coming back. As of this morning, I have resigned from the force. You see, not so long ago, I took wedding vows myself. They meant everything to me that day, and they still do now. I know my first duty is to my wife. But I'm proud of you all as a team. I want to thank you for the hard work you do, for the service you give to this community. I'll miss this part of Yorkshire. I'll miss you. That's enough. Good luck.
An ambulance?
No, no, you don't. Doctors have agreed to let me take you by car.
Hi.
Upbeat is back at Christmas, but next Sunday, the Royal returns.
All set for the big day tomorrow, then?
As I'll ever be.
The toast is wedded bliss.
Wedded bliss.
Oh, I said you'd look lovely in that dress.
Give me at least 20 minutes before it's safe for your people to go in.
Officer, they're in there already!